हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम ऑन माय यूट्यूब चैनल माइक्रोबायोलॉजी बाय संतोष नत्ते। फ्रेंड्स, फ्रॉम लास्ट वीक वी हैव स्टार्टेड सम टिप्स और वीडियो लेक्चर्स टू इम्प्रूव द नॉलेज ऑफ योर इंटरव्यूज एज वेल एज वी आर आल्सो अपलोडिंग द वीडियोज रिगार्डिंग स्किल्स एंड द नॉलेज required for the interviews in pharmaceutical industries as well as food industries or other industries, and all these videos are created keeping in view microbiology students as well as biotechnology students. So friends, if you have not subscribed this microbiology by Santosh Napte, kindly subscribe this channel so that you will get notifications regarding the upcoming videos on the preparation of job interviews. So without wasting time, we will start today's lecture, and our today's topic is bioburden test or the microbial limit test for pharmaceutical products, because in pharmaceutical industries there is a different types of pharmaceutical products are produced, and it is very essential to perform this test on these pharmaceutical products here or before sterilization. Now in today's topic, we are going to study about the what is bioburden test. Then we will see about the that is bioburden test or microbial limit test. Then we will see about the purpose of this bioburden test, then the products for which this bioburden test is conducted or the use for the products, and then we will see this bioburden test for which it is used, and lastly we will see about the procedure in brief. So in this today's lecture, we will see the procedure of this bioburden test lastly, but in brief, and in next video we will see detail about the procedure or actual how this bioburden test is performed, that we will see in the next lecture. So without wasting time, again we will start this bioburden test. So what is this bioburden test? So bioburden is defined as the number of contaminated organisms found in a given amount of material before undergoing a sterilization procedure. Because all of you know that there is a API is there in pharmaceutical industry. API means active pharmaceutical ingredients that is present in each medicine or drug. So that is called as API or active pharmaceutical ingredient, and this active pharmaceutical ingredient, it is sterilized before used in the final product or for the production of this or manufacturing of the final product. So before that or before sterilizing that product or that API or any other material, there is a number of contaminating organisms are present on that raw material, we can see here, and the number of these contaminated organisms which are found on this on a given amount of that material before later sterilization procedure, so that is called as the bioburden. So what is the purpose of this bioburden determination or test? So the purpose of this bioburden test is to count or to enumerate the quantity of viable microorganisms on pharmaceutical product, medical device, component, raw material or the packaging material before sterilization. So all these materials it has to sterilize, but whatever the quantity of microorganisms or contaminating microorganisms are present on this materials before sterilization procedure, that is the bioburden. And the purpose of this bioburden test is to enumerate or to count the quantity of these viable microorganisms on this product. So this bioburden testing, it is also very important indicator of problems in the production process, which could lead to a product recalls later, that is from the market. So that is the very important purpose of this bioburden testing. Then this bioburden testing, it is performed on pharmaceutical products and medical products for the quality control purposes, because it is very essential to maintain the quality of the final product. And this, the one part of this quality control purposes, it is one of the bioburden testing. Then the products or the components which are used in the pharmaceutical or medical field, they require control of microbial levels that should be free of microorganisms, or that does not cross the limit of that microorganisms. So they require the control of microbial levels during processing as well as handling. So that is also the one important purpose here. And this bioburden or microbial limit testing on these products, it proves that all the requirements have been met which are required for the that final microbial product to launched. So these are the different products on which that bioburden test is performed, and that includes medical devices, pharmaceuticals, then packaging material, raw materials, then human tissues, animal tissues, as well as cosmetics. Then these bioburden tests, or whatever the results which are obtained of these bioburden tests, that can be used for different purposes. And one of that use is to demonstrate the microbial quality control of the manufacturing process through a routine monitoring. Then it determines the radiation dose for terminally sterilized product, because according to the bioburden results, there is a determination of radiation dose for the terminal sterilization of the product. Then it is used to investigate root cause of contamination from routine production. Then the results of bioburden test, these are also used to test the raw as well as finished product materials for microbiological examination of non-sterile products. And these are used to test raw and finished product materials for microbiological or non-sterile products here. So this is the procedure or how this bioburden test is performed. This is in brief I am explaining here, but in next video we will see in detail about the aim, procedure, requirement as well as result of this bioburden test. So the first step for bioburden test is preparation of sample. So this sample of the test product is prepared according to their physical characteristics of the product, and generally water soluble products, then non-fatty products, these are not water soluble, and that fatty products, then fluids or solids in aerosol or transdermal patches, they each require the different types of solvents. So this is the first step, that is preparation of sample. Second one is here isolation of microorganisms or growing culturing of microorganisms. And the samples, these are typically tested on membrane filtration method or plate count method. And the another method which is used here, that is most probable number. Then next step is here culturing of microorganisms. Then after taking that sample on the membrane filtration media or that plate, and in plate count agar or an MPN, so that there is an incubation period is there, then temperature should have to maintain, and culture media. So they are incubated for this specific period. Next step is here enumeration of microorganisms. So there is a one, these companies techniques are used here, and that is total aerobic microbial count or TAMC and total yeast and mold count. And final step is here preparation of report. So as per the result, that reports are recorded and then conclusion is drawn. So this is about the procedure of this bioburden test in brief. So friends, watch this video and read more about the bioburden test from your record book or from your any material which is available on the net. We will see the video in next lecture. So thank you for watching this video.